are pigments. Some animals will get inside of their display and they will give them their food by hand. Now what this means is you can keep a close eye on who is eating and who isn't, who's nice and healthy and who isn't. It also means that we can create a good relationship between our aquas and our penguins as well, meaning that our penguins, of course, trust us, which is always brilliant to have.
Good. See, you can see the penguins.
Now, as I say, we have 17 gentoo penguins inside of this enclosure.
Yeah, they were coming to you, look.
And we have 10 females. Maybe think of the missing one out there. Well, this extra penguin is actually a little baby penguin, so we're not too sure whether they're a boy or a girl yet. Now, to find out if a gentoo penguin is a boy or a girl, it is very difficult indeed, as their reproductive organs are hidden very well under that thick layer of rubber or fat. So by sight, you can tell. The only way to tell if a gentoo penguin is a boy or a girl is by being in the air. It's probably around 3 hours old. We've not yet got the results of our DNA test. We're not too sure yet, but a bit
fall down. The penguin fall down.
All our penguins are still made apart by the boards that are surrounding penguin points. So you can see there's colours of their bands and
they were coming to you. Look, he's there.
Hi.
Penguin is there. Look.
You can find their names by using the bands and the paws around the penguin. Now, a quick way to tell whether they're a girl
where
or a boy
they?
Is to swing this band is on. If they have a band on their left wing, then they're most certainly a girl. If they have a band on their right wing, they're most certainly a boy. Birds, which means, of course, when it comes to making their offspring, they're always going to lay eggs. Now, their mating season starts around early spring and ends around late June, and it all starts off with a pebble. So, around late February, we're
coming to you.
This when I'm able to going to search through them all to try and find their favourites. Now, once they've found their favourite pebble, they're going to present it to their favourite female pebble, and they can look it at their feet. Now, a female penguin then has a choice. They're either going to accept this pebble or they're going to reject this pebble. It's a little bit like a mini penguin. Now, if they accept this pebble, it means that our penguin has then mated for life. They're never going to go off and find the mate. They'll only be the two penguins. Now, once they've mated, they'll actually start to build nests to use their favourite pebble as just building blocks for their
egg.
Let's go! 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 Let's go